Dear students, today we are going to start with the topic shares and dividends. You all are aware of the word shares and dividends, as in general you are listening these words on the television. The whole present commercial world is simply based on the share market, like Reliance, Tata, Vodafone, Big Bazaar, Zomato. All these, they are just running on the basis of shares. To start any big business in the form of any company or industry, a large sum of money is required, which is not possible for any particular person or individual to arrange. Then this large sum is collected in the form of small units from the public, and these small units are called shares, and thus the company also becomes the public company, not anyone's individual company, as it is formed by the money of public, because public has invested the money in this. And the persons purchasing these shares are called shareholders. Now, let us discuss about the few terms. First is nominal value. So the nominal value is the original value of the shares issued by the company at the time of its starting or growth. It is also known as the face value or printed value or register value of the shares. Now, second term is market value. The price at which the shares can be purchased or sold from the market is called its market value. This value is fluctuable as it depends on the growth or downfall of any company. And one thing more, while purchasing or selling the market in the share, you can't sell the shares or purchase the shares from the market. It is done through the brokers. So brokerage is also charged, but this is not in the syllabus of ICSC. It is in the syllabus of CBSE board. So I'm not explaining about it, but shares can't be purchased or sold directly from the market. It is done through the brokers. Now, note down, when market value is equal to nominal value, then shares are said to be at par. Second case, when market value is greater than nominal value, then the shares are said to be premium shares or above par shares. And third is, when market value is less than nominal value, then the shares are said to be discounted shares or below par shares. Now, talking about the term dividend, at the end of every financial year, company declares its income, which is divided equally among the shareholders in proportion of their investments in the company. That is, it depends upon the number of shares any shareholder owns. It is also known as the income or profit. Over here, you have to note two things. That first is, dividend is always expressed as percentage of the nominal value of the shares. And second, dividend is always calculated on the nominal value of the shares. Now, there are a few formulas which are very, very useful while solving the sums. And they are, first is number of shares. Number of shares is equal to total nominal value of shares upon nominal value of one share. It is also equal to total market value of the shares. And this total market value of the shares is also known as investment or total cost price upon market value of one share. And it is also equal to total dividend or total annual income or total profit upon dividend per share. Here I am going to express dividend per share or income per share by the word DPS. We can equate any two terms in this formula as per the requirement of the sum. Like number of shares, we can equate it is equal to investment upon market value of one share, or number of shares is equal to total dividend upon dividend per share. So whatever is the need of the hour while doing the sum, we can make application of that. Coming to the second one, total investment or the sum invested or the total cost price is equal to number of shares into market value of one share. This formula is gained from the first case, that number of shares is equal to total market value or the of the shares, that is investment upon market value of one share. So total investment is equal to number of shares into market value of one share. Third is annual income or total dividend is equal to number of shares into dividend per share. I've already represented DPS is dividend per share. Then fourth is dividend or income per share is equal to rate of dividend into nominal value of one share. Now, fifth is rate of interest on the investment. It is also known as yield percent, or sometimes it is written given as return percentage. So formula for this is total dividend or total annual income upon total investment into 100. Just like profit percent is equal to profit upon total cost price into 100, over here percentage return or yield percent is equal to total dividend upon total investment into 100. Now, one more thing you have to remember, that profit percent on market value is equal to dividend percent into nominal value. Now, sometimes you have to note down, sometimes the statement comes as shares at par. Generally, it means that the nominal value of one share is rupees 100, which is not mentioned. And second case, sometimes the word sale proceeds comes. It means the new investment after selling the shares, the revenue obtained is invested in purchasing the new type of shares. So it is also known as new investment. So remember, we will take the dividend along with the money received after selling the shares from the new investment only if it is mentioned in the question, otherwise not. Like when we are talking about the term sale proceed, so in case if it is mentioned in the question that you have to include the dividend, previous dividend along with the money obtained on selling the shares, then only you will add the dividend, otherwise only sale proceed is equal to new investment, that is the money obtained after selling the shares. Okay. Now, third thing, now suppose the statement is given as 20% of rupees 50 shares at rupees 75. So how you will read? It means the nominal value of one share is rupees 50. The market value of one share is rupees 75. The dividend or the profit on one share is 20 upon 100 into 50, because 20% is the rate of dividend. And you know that dividend is calculated on nominal value. So 20 upon 100 into 50, that is rupees 10. The income on rupees 75 shares is rupees 10 per annum. Now let us discuss few sums on the basis of this. Like question number one, how much money will be required to buy rupees by 125 rupees 30 shares at a discount of rupees 3? So how we will proceed in this? Before starting with the sum, I just want to tell you that while starting with any sum, firstly note down all the information given in the sum and then proceed. Like over here, number of shares is 125. Nominal value of one share is rupees 30. Market value of one share is 30 minus rupees 3 because it is discounted share. So it is 27. So money required or the investment which is being asked is equal to number of shares into market value of one share. That is 125 into 27, and it will give you rupees 3375 as the investment. Now coming to sum number two, a man invests rupees 7770 in a company paying 5% dividend when a share of nominal value of rupees 100 shall set a premium of rupees 5. Find the number of shares bought, second part annual income, third part percentage income. So first of all, we will write what is given to us. Investment is equal to rupees 7770, rate of dividend is equal to 5%, number of nominal value of one share is equal to rupees 100, and market value of one share is equal to rupees 100 plus rupees 5 because it is a premium share, that is 105 rupees is the market value. Now for finding the first part, number of shares is equal to investment upon market value of one share. That is 7770 upon market value is given as 105. On solving, you will get 74 shares. For the second part, annual income. You know that annual income is equal to number of shares into dividend per share. So number of shares we have already found in the first part, that is 74, and dividend per share, rate of dividend is already given as 5%. So 5 upon 100 into 100. 100 is the nominal value. So after solving this, you will get rupees 370 as the annual income. Third part, percentage income. I told you that percentage income is equal to total income upon total investment into 100. So it is equal to 370, which we have obtained in the second part as the total in annual income upon total investment is already given in the beginning. That is 770 into 100. And after solving this, you will get 4.76% as the percentage income. So what have you observed in this? That whenever in any question, suppose three parts are given, then all the parts are helping each other. Like the first part, that is number of shares, we have used in the second part for finding the annual income. And the second part, that is annual income, we have used in the third part, that is for finding the percentage income. So in 99% questions, whenever there are many subparts, then all the subparts help each other. Okay. And they are meant for each other. Now, talking about question number three, which I have chosen. Mr. Sharma has 60 shares of nominal value, rupees 100, and decides to sell them when So over here, we are going to start with the third problem. That is, Mr. Sharma has 60 shares of nominal value, rupees 100, and he decides to sell them when they are at a premium of 60%. He invests the proceeds in shares of nominal value or rupees 50 quoted at 4% discount and paying 18% dividend annually. Calculate the first part is sale proceeds. Second is the number of shares he buys. third part, his annual dividend from the shares. So initially it is given that number of shares is 60. Nominal value of one share is rupees 100. And market value of one share is rupees 100 plus 60% of 100, because they are the premium shares. So 100 plus 60 upon 100 into 100 will give you 160 rupees as the market value of one share. Now, as I told you that in case of sale proceed, like the first part is sale proceeds, that is the new investment. I told you in the beginning that it is equal to number of shares into market value of one share, that is 60 into 160, that is rupees 9,600 is the sale proceed, and it will become the new investment. Now, in the second part, they have asked about the number of shares he buys. So now we know that new investment is rupees 9,600, and nominal value in the second case, it is given as rupees 50. And market value of one share is 50 minus 4% of 50, because it is given 4% discount, as they are the discounted shares, which will give you rupees 48 as the market value of one share. And rate of dividend is already mentioned in the question as 18%. So number of shares in the second part, it is equal to investment upon market value of one share. Investment we have already found in the first part, that is 9600 upon 48, which will give you 200 shares. Now for finding the third part, that is his annual dividend from the shares or annual income. It is equal to number of shares into dividend per share. As I told you the formula in the beginning, number of shares we have got in the second part, that is 200 into dividend per share, because rate of dividend is 18%. So 18 upon 100 into 50, because 50 is the nominal value. And after solving this, you will get rupees 1800 as the annual dividend. So you have seen that the first part, that is sale proceed, has helped the second part for finding the number of shares. And number of shares, that is 200, has helped in the third part for finding the annual dividend. So as I told you that in any question, whenever the three or four parts are given, then in 99% cases, again, I'm saying that they are helping each other as you proceed. Now coming to question number four, divide rupees 50,760 into two parts, such that if one part is invested in 8% rupees 100 shares at 8% discount, and the other is 9% rupees 100 shares at 8% premium, the annual incomes from both the investments are equal. So over here, we have to divide this rupees 50,760. So what I have done, I have taken the first part, suppose it is X. So but obvious, the second part is 50,760 minus X. So our first investment is suppose X, and the second investment is 50,760 minus X. So we will divide it into two groups. In the first case, rate of dividend is 8%. Nominal value of one share is rupees 100. Market value of one share is 100 minus 8% of 100, because it is discounted, because it is given in the question that at 8% discount, so market value will become 92. Now I told you the formula that investment upon market value of one share is equal to total dividend upon dividend per share. So over here, the total dividend which we will get, I have represented by TT1. So X upon, because the investment is X, market value is 92. Total dividend which we are going to get, I have represented by TT1 upon dividend per share, 8% of 100, because 100 is the nominal value. So after solving this, you will get TD1 as 2x upon 23. That is total dividend in the first case. First investment is 2x upon 23. Now let us discuss the second part also in the similar manner. That investment is 50,760 minus x. rate of dividend in the second case, it is given as 9%. Nominal value of one share is rupees 100. And market value of one share is 100 plus 8% of 100. Because it is given at 8% premium. So you will get market value of one share as 108. Similarly, we will proceed that investment upon market value of one share is equal to total dividend. In the second case, I have represented by TD2 upon dividend per share. So 50,760 minus X upon 108 is equal to total dividend in the second case upon 9 upon 100 into 100, because over here also nominal value is 100. So after solving this case, we have got the second dividend as 50,760 minus X upon 12. Now, as per the information given in the question, that the annual incomes from both the investments are equal. That is, total dividend in the first case is equal to total dividend in the second case. And now we will put the values. So 2x upon 23 is equal to 50,760 minus x upon 12. After solving this, you will get the value of x as rupees 24,840. So X was our first investment, and the second investment was 50,760 minus X. So 50,760 minus 24,840, which is the value of X we have got. And so second investment will be rupees 25,920. Now let us discuss question number 5. Which is the better investment? 16% rupees 100 shares at 80 or 20% rupees 100 shares at rupees 120. So in this case, the formula which I told, that profit percent on market value is equal to dividend percent on nominal value. We will apply this formula. So in the first case, like if we apply this formula, that profit percent on market value is equal to dividend percent on nominal value. So profit percent means, suppose P upon 100 into market value is what? 80 is equal to 16%, because it is already given 16% as the dividend percent and nominal value is given as 100. So after solving this, we have got the value of profit percent as 20% in the first case. We have got the profit as 20%. In the first case. Similarly, we will proceed in the second case, that profit percent on nominal value, on market value, is equal to dividend percent into on nominal value. Over here, by mistake, I've written market value. So it is nominal value. So profit upon 100 into 12, because profit upon 100 into 120, because 120 is the market value, is equal to 20%, means 20 upon 100 into 100, because nominal value is given as 100. So after solving this in the second case, we have got the profit percent as 16.66%, which is less than the first profit, that is 20%. So, but obvious, first investment gives the better profit. So first investment is better. So these are some, we can apply this formula, that profit percent on market value is equal to dividend percent on nominal value. Now coming to one and the last case, so that you can proceed. A man invests rupees 20,020 in buying shares of nominal value rupees 26 at 10% premium. The dividend on the shares is 15% per annum. Calculate, first part is number of shares he buys, second part the dividend he receives annually, and third part the rate of interest he gets on his money. This question has been asked 2 times in the board examination. Now, for solving this, first of all, we will write what is given to us. That is, investment is 20,020 rupees, nominal value of one share is rupees 26, and market value of one share is rupees 26 plus 10% of 26 because it is given 10% premium. So 26 plus 2.6 will give you market value of one share as 28.6 rupees. And rate of dividend is already given as 15% per annum. So for finding the first part, you are aware that number of shares is equal to investment upon market value of one share. That is 20,020 upon 28.6, which is given as the market value of one share. After solving this, you will get number of shares as 700. Now, for finding the annual dividend, you know the formula that annual dividend is equal to number of shares into dividend per share. Number of shares we have already found in the first part, that is 700, and dividend per share is equal to 15 upon 100 into 26. So you will get the final answer as rupees 2730. So for finding the third part, that is the rate of interest. Rate of interest can be found by the formula which I told in the beginning, that it is equal to total annual dividend upon total investment into 100. That is 2730. And annual dividend we have already got in the second part. Okay. And total investment is already given in the beginning. That is 20,020 into 100. So 2730 upon 20020 into 100. And that will give you 13.63%. So over here in this case also, you have seen the first part, that is number of shares, has helped you in the second part for obtaining the annual dividend. And the annual dividend which you have got in the second part has helped you in the third part for obtaining the rate of interest. So again, it is the same case. I'm telling you that in any sum, if number of parts are given, then they are helping each other, okay, as you proceed. So applying these formulas and these concepts, students, you can try the sums from the different exercises which are given in the book. And in case of any query or any question or any doubt, you can WhatsApp me on my personal number. Okay, that's all.